everything. We're understanding everything that is going on. All speech, everything is preserved.
Well, okay, I'm asking you. You have said.
I just told you.
You said
everything.
There are seven.
When did I say seven? When did I say seven?
Yeah, there are seven Quran.
When did I say seven?
You said there are seven recitations.
When did I say that?
You just said that.
No, I did not. You're not listening. I would like you to listen carefully.
I am asking you.
I said,
believe there are seven recitations of Quran.
Let me tell you once more. We have 10 mutawatir qira'at of the Quran.
No, yeah? I heard seven. And I read seven.
And I'm telling you again. The word is 10. T-E-N and 10.
Do you have the evidence for that?
No. Do you know what I believe in?
Yes.
There are 10 authentic transmitted readings of the Quran. How many? 7 or 10?
You said 10. Do you have the evidence?
Wait. 10, right?
Why 10?
So this is
and
my belief.
Do you have the evidence?
This is my belief. So do you want to talk about my belief or do you want to talk about evidence?
Right, you have to prove it. Why 10 and where are these 10?
You claim there were 7.
Yeah, is what I'm asking.
Wait, 1 second. So you can go and pick up in a bookshop the 10 authentic Qira'at Mushafs individually or collectively.
Why? First of all, why has to be 10 different recitation, and then where they
would
are?
Would you be happy with 11?
10 are first time
online.
I heard the 10. The number 10,
okay.
Honestly, I first time heard that.
Sure.
I know in Sahih Bukhari, I read somebody said, well, Muhammad supposedly, there are 7 recitations of Quran.
No, you're getting mixed up with two things.
I want to say, where are these 7 recitations?
Okay, let me just ease your life with this.
That will help.
Firstly, to help you with this, if you are someone who is looking for the truth. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the Quran was revealed on 7 letters, not the recitation. Now,
ahruf.
Ahruf. The ahruf here, which is the Arabic dialogue, that how the Arabs used to speak. Now, sometimes, which is, for example, taqdeem and ta'khir, sometimes, will bring the noun before the pronoun, and it depends how the dialect of the Arabic they speak. So not necessarily ways of recitation, not necessarily the one which we have nowadays, doesn't necessarily represent the Ahruf which was at the time of the Prophet, those ones. Now, and as well, it contains those ones, meaning all the way that the 10 Qira'at, which is nowadays, it contains these 7 Ahruf. It contains all of them. So, but it is a very detailed and very complicated, for example, a topic, which is for you just to say, oh, it's a 7 recitation. No, it's not necessarily like that.
Can you explain what does it mean?
Did you understand the difference between Qira'at and Ahruf?
Is it an accent?
Did you hear the difference?
Please don't involve my question.
Okay. That's
what is the difference? Okay. What difference should I see
I'm answering.
D7, one of the two seven?
Yeah, there are the dialect, as you said, they are part of it, the accent, part of it. There are sometimes taqdeem and ta'khir. There are sometimes, for example, it depends how, for example, those the Arab tongues, which is amongst this, within the Arab Peninsula, how they used to, for example, sometimes. They need, for example, extra explanation for certain things.
Yeah.
So due to this, that this is the 7 ahruf, is contained within the 10 recitation which is now. Meaning all of them, they are contained in here.
Okay. I read in Sahih Bukhari, when Usman was commanding to Ibn Sabit to collect Quran, he clearly said to him, write it in Quraishi. Why you would say, 10, which I never read.
Fine.
I know there are 7 been said by Muhammad.
He didn't say that.
Yes.
Uthman didn't say that.
Muhammad said 7, you're saying 10.
Uthman didn't
and
say
whereas
that.
Usman said it has to be Quraishi only.
No. I will tell you
why it's come up to be 10.
I will tell
now
you
we have 26.
Hold on a second. I will tell you Uthman didn't say only Quraishi. Uthman said if there is a dispute on certain verse, then go back how the Quraysh are reciting it. Meaning if there is 2 witnesses for each verse that the Prophet ﷺ has recited it in this way, they will keep it. Yeah? Now if there is a difference in something which is they will dispute amongst them, then they will go back in the way that how the Quraysh recited it.
So there are controversial verses?
No, there is no controversy.
That's a proof There were controversial verses.
You understand what I
think,
said?
I think you understand what I said.
Why are you
that?
You understand what I said? Are you seriously saying, ingenuinely, what you're saying, or are you genuinely saying that? My saying to you, if there is a dispute on a verse, meaning it's not controversial.
That means there was.
No.
Yeah, that means there was. Why are you warning them?
In the way of recitation. You understand?
When it came down to writing down, do you write tabut or tabut? For example, an example about tabu and tabut.
Yeah.
Do you write with an open ta or with a closed ta? How do you write this in terms of when there's a dispute between, you have people from Mecca, people from Medina writing, right? The mashaf during compilation. They would write in the way they have taught, in the way of writing.
Which we do in Bible.
Don't bring Bible in, sorry. I cannot continue this discussion if you bring Bible in here, right? Bible is a separate discussion.
It's fine.
Bible is a separate discussion altogether.
It's okay.
So when it comes to the Quran, you need to understand the two key concepts. One is ahruf, and the other one is qira'at. We were talking about 10 qira'at from the 7 ahruf. Yeah?
Okay.
7 ahruf is 7 ahruf. But ahruf the 10 qira'at are
spelling.
No.
What
no.
is that? Aruf is the letter.
I explained to you how many times.
You just said Aruf is the letter.
I said.
Is the alphabet? Is the spelling?
You see? That will be
okay.
The problem.
Okay, explain to me what does Aruf means?
Look, I explained to you, I'll do repeat again. It is a way the Arab tongues, how they used to be. So they sometimes will use taqdim and ta'khir. Will bring sometimes the noun forward before the, for example, before the verb, and so on and so forth. Here, it's a way that the Arabs used to say, used to speak, how they speak. They sometimes will bring the noun before the verb, and sometimes they will bring the verb before the noun. It depends how they speak.
No,
you didn't interrupt me. I heard you, so you need to hear me now. Now, so this is a way, this one thing. That's
why
one
you
example.
Want to do that? Why?
I didn't finish. Don't interrupt me, please. I mean, I could jump in your speaking every moment. Yeah.
Excuse me.
I have respect for you, though.
You speak five times than me.
It doesn't matter. That's my time.
Sorry, one second. You speak five times than me. If you ask a question, is the answer shorter than the question? Or sometimes it can be longer?
No, you don't even let me the question.
Wait. When you ask a question,
why? I'm asking,
do you think the answer will be...
I don't even have time to make a question.
Sorry.
Listen.
I don't think this discussion is fruitful, Sheikh.
Why you would say that?
He's being very, very.
If Arabic is not qualified for the holy book of Allah, is not standardized. It's an illiterate nation.
Good.
Arabic is not a qualified language.
Did you finish?
For a holy book to be written.
Did you finish your nonsense?
It's not nonsense.
Did you finish your nonsense?
You're insulting me.
Because it's nonsense. Come on. What you said is nonsense.
I made a point.
Okay. It is the ancient, one of the ancient language, which is not just that. It is the richest language in the world. Not qualified. If you don't know, read and understand. Read even non-Muslim historian what they said about Arabic. Then you come back and talk about Arabic. So this what you said is nonsense. I will just avoid what you said and go back to the Ahruf. So again, I said to you, it's a way of the speak. Ahruf, the direct meaning of Ahruf in Arabic means letters. But here, when the Prophet ﷺ, he said that the Quran was revealed on 7 Ahruf, not necessarily that they are letters. We are talking about the way that the sentence is formed. And this is the miracle of the Quran. That's how is it. For example, the Quran came to people of language, came to Meccan people, and they used to know all these dialects, they used to know all of these type of Ahruf. When they came to them, why do you think they were amazed by the structure of the Quran? Because the structure of the Quran is so sophisticated, as in Arabic language, to the extent it made them to be amazed by this book. And that's made them to challenge. That's the Quran. The Quran challenged them and told them, if the Quran is easy, it's simple language, the Quran came and challenged them just to bring one chapter, which is three lines. They couldn't bring even three lines. Why?
Where is this 7 recitation? Where?
That's
a fabricated hadith, I believe. If you don't have the proof,
he's a muhaddith.
It's fabricated.
Speak according to muhaddith.
Okay.
Now, if you don't have the proof of these 7, don't make the quote of it.
Fine.
Okay. Ignore it.
I will tell you how.
If you say, I will answer you.
I will answer you. These, the 10 qira'at, which is nowadays, they contain the 7 ahruf. For example, Allah said in the Quran, for example, Maliki yawmiddin. And Allah said in the Quran, Maliki yawmiddin. And both are acceptable recitation. What's the meaning of Malik? Meaning the owner of the Day of Judgment. Maliki Yawm al-Din, the king of the day of judgment. So here it doesn't, again, this is the beauty of the Quran. And by the way, amazingly, they are written the same. Malik and Malik. Yeah, Malik and Malik. Both of them are written the same. And one of the other one, Malik, it has a small alif which is on top. Another
can place in the Quran.
Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu in ja'akum fasiqun binaba'in fatabayyanu. Allah said. And Allah said as well in the Quran, fatathabbatu. So, fatabayyanu, when you write it, it is exactly written the same. If you remove the letter, if you remove all the dots and anything, so fatabayyanu, fatathabbatu is written the same. But here, this is how the Arabic, they spoke about it, and so there's some people that understand this way.
Can you name these 10 recitations?
So he has not been listening to what what you said.
I couldn't name.
He's fixated with...
No. Okay. Why we have, today we have 26 different recitations?
No, where do you get that from?
We have 10.
Where do you get 26 from?
We have collected
10. We have 26 10 mutawatirah.
No, why 26?
What if I give you 80?
How many?
Whatever, if I give you 80, 80.
80.
Where did you get your 26 from?
So you disapprove by yourself?
Wait, one second. Where did you get your 26 from?
Seven recitations was not real.
One moment.
The 10 ones are, they are mutawatir, meaning, firstly, the condition for each one which is to be accepted, firstly, that it has to be on the harf of Uthman, meaning on the how the Uthman, at his time, how the Sahaba, they get together.
On the consonantal skeleton of the Uthmanic Rasul.
Uthmanic.
Number one.
The vowels?
Are you listening?
What the vowels in the time of Uthman?
One second. What did we say the first condition was?
We said it has to be consonantal.
Of what? Of who?
Of the text.
Whose text?
You just said that.
No, whose text?
Of Quran.
No.
Come on, speak up. Say again.
Concentrate. Focus. If you don't focus and concentrate, you're wasting your valuable time.
No, exactly
time.
Repeat what you said.
Okay.
No, I didn't say that.
No. You said the consonantal.
I said Uthmanic. Consonantal skeleton, Rasam of Uthman, Rasam Uthmani.
Is it what exactly I said?
What?
It has to agree in consonantal.
What is the Rasam?